out and watch it. And definitely, I told my dad, my husband, like, he asked me, don't give me that money. Maybe I'm not going to put it for you because we're going to start. I have to save that money to send it to that boy. Because June is coming, people are going to see outside. So I have to send that money to him to make a little place for them so that they don't get wet. And after that, we just came back from Cameroon. And I was planning to get a place to build this church. And when I went there, the guy only sold the place. Oh my God, I was not happy about it. So with this spirit in me, I tried to beg the Holy Ghost to control me when I get angry. Beg. The next day, we got a land. Not even that small one that a guy sold. Had 2 acres of land. 2 acres of land that one guy, the friend just said, okay, wait, I am connecting. Just connect. And they gave us a big 2 acre land for my church. Oh my goodness, I'm not going to do a church there. A group home will be there. Oh, Jesus, everything is just falling in place. You know?
See how she's happy. Help to the work of God.
Yes, it's just like in my stomach.
So and then this whole program is just best birthday. And you canceled the wedding you were supposed to go 2 days before this program.
I was supposed to go to a wedding to go stand and dance. No, let me come and praise God. For giving me one more year for everything that He has done. I don't lack. I have a home. I have a business. Everything is good, but I lack something inside.
Hey!
I was so depressed. Hey! I was still sitting in my bed. One more, I'll be in bed looking at the sky. My husband, oh God, I used to be in bed. I don't know what is wrong with me. There's money. There's food. There's everything there. There's something that is lacking inside me. So everything, I'm just so depressed. I started. Then finally God started coming to me. I was praying to Him. The only thing I want from God is to spend the rest of my life worshiping Him. And He should send me somebody to take me through this route. First, I don't know, the Bible is too huge. Where am I going to start?
The Bible is too huge.
And I've been begging, going to this pastor, going to this one. The right, some of them call me. Oh, I am this. I said, where did you get my number from? No, they'll be telling me somewhere they got my number. I said, I don't know you. I'll go to this prayer line, it doesn't fit. I'll go to this prayer line, my spirit talks to me, it doesn't fit. So finally, I was watching before. Then this my friend came and was. What happened in Baltimore? Then I met another man of God from that too. My spirit clicked with them. I'm getting peace now. The word of God is coming. I am so much peaceful. What I'm begging God is gradually giving it to me. I'm knowing the Bible and He's giving me people like her and that other man of God. All of them are Nigerians. The other one is Pastor Sunday. So they are just keeping me very fruitful, very blessed. Please, thank you, woman of God. May God continue to bless you, God. I told God that you go to this man of God and convince you, go to this one and beg God that if He makes me to use me, I just want to build a house that they will not take no, they will pass offering fine for church, but no harassing people for money. You understand? Because I've been there. I've been seeking for God. People will come and they tell you stories. People will come and tell you stories. But there are real people out there. There are real people out there. Look at what she's doing. You know, see, I'm chilling. You know, I can start telling you my testimony tomorrow. But God has been so nice and faithful. You know, in time, but we'll see next time I'll be here. Definitely, she said she will not come. She will come. Yeah, yeah, because the singing will need it again.
Now, come back because of the singing. Come back, clap for her. She's not so happy. You guys remember when she came the first day? saying she was supposed to be at a wedding, and just 2 days before this program, she canceled the wedding and said she's coming here to spend her birthday. Her birthday was yesterday. Was it yesterday we sang happy birthday to her? And she and her husband have been here the whole 3 days. I actually saw them at the airport when I was coming in. Yeah, and look at her. Most of the things she's saying, I was talking about them here. You guys remember? So I was speaking to her too. I didn't even remember. I'm so happy for you.
Came, I slept and I saw you came to like you is you is so big
the night on Friday night.
Oh, it's not Friday night. I told him just for me like this and I said whoa. I said thank you. I which kind of a big man is this? You know, but I can see your face, you understand? And then yesterday I was sleeping, I got up. Suddenly I cannot sleep. I started praying. I read my psalms and as I prayed. As I went back to bed, I saw a man again standing and trying to flush my ears. I said, ah, this man won't flush. What's wrong with my ears now? I was not really sleeping, but the man stood there. He said, I want to flush your ears.
Your ears are opening. Wow.
Yeah, that's what the man is about.
Are you guys here? Remember, I was praying for you guys yesterday. Your ears were open, your eyes were open.
Amen.
So, our ears, Jesus came and opened your ears so you can Amen. Hear from God.
Amen.
Can you guys clap for Jesus? This was yesterday. Wow. You remember, I said, some of you will dream and you will see these things happen. Before you know, she will hear clearly from God. Flush your ear means it's blocked. I need to open it, remove the wax. Wow, this is a powerful dream. How many of you want your ears flushed? Everybody.
I love you guys.
Yeah, put your finger in your ears. Don't believe. It's going to happen. Father, the same way you have opened your daughter's ear, these ones, they believe. Even the ones online. Even my girls are putting hand in their ear. Flush their ears. Open their ears. Remove that wax that is blocking them from hearing from you. In the name of Jesus. And let them begin to hear your voice clearly. In the name of Jesus. Also give them that gift of discernment. Let them know when it's you that is speaking. Let them not confuse your voice with their own imagination or with the voice of the enemy. In the name of Jesus. It is done in Jesus' name. Put your hand like on your eyes. Close your eyes and like this. As you have opened their ears, also open their spiritual eyes. Let them see what you want them to see. In the name of Jesus. Whatever they have used to close their eyes, I remove that thing right now. I rinse their eyes with the blood of Jesus. From today, you will begin to see clearly what God wants you to see. In the name of Jesus, you are free. In Jesus' name. Oh my God, when I was praying that prayer, I felt that it was a strong anointing. Hallelujah. Mom, sometimes when I pray this prayer, people hear pop in their ear. Like something pop. And they start to hear God. Because the devil blocks you from hearing. And sometimes it makes you confused. You would think it's God speaking, but it's not God. That's why I pray for that discernment. So you know. Because a lot of people have been misled by the wrong voice. I'm telling you, so you will not be misled in the name of Jesus. I'm really enjoying this vacation. Are you guys having a great time? Can you believe we've been here for 3 days? We're not even so many of us, but we've had so much fun. Is there anybody else that has there was 3 or 4 testimonies. Come on, sweetie. You were here on Friday. You told me you had to work yesterday. And you still made it. You came right on time when we shared the dresses.
Yes, I was at work.
And yours looked so beautiful.
Yes, watching online yesterday.
Oh, you were watching yesterday even though you were working.
I was telling you to turn that phone off.
She was at work watching us yesterday. Go ahead, sweetie.
Okay, I've been following online for a while. Sometime last year, I keep telling my friend, I said, you know, I used to do a hospital visitation praying for the sick. And I had stopped. Why my life has been so tormented. And I continue to tell her that I need to go back. I went back in March, and the Lord began to speak to me. I came here and said, I've been praying for my daughter. every time she's off, I see if I'm going to church, but she's tired, she has everything to do. So I came here on Friday, she said, to tell God what you want done. I said, God, I call my daughter into the kingdom. Early this morning, I was sleeping about 8 o'clock, the phone rang. And she said, Mommy, what time church starting? I said, I'm 8, but I don't know, going there until like 9:30. So I thought she's calling me to come get my grandson. So after I was dressed, I called the front of the feast already. She said, no, you don't have to come to me. My mommy's going to come to church. Ooh. And she didn't know when we come to church, she went to the altar. Ooh. She went to the altar and started to go over there. Then I come back into church. But she's always busy. She's always working, and she works here at Atlantis. I left here, I got up to her office, and I just told her I was cleaning the blood. I said, every demon in here is walking around. Amen. I said, oh, I canceled it. I said, no, when you come. And I talked to her church this morning because I'm an evangelist also. I went to the altar and I prayed and I said, God, everybody she come in contact with today, their life will never be the same.
Amen.
And I give God the honor and the
glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And your prayer request from Friday was answered. And your daughter came to church.
And he told me, if you be obedient to the call that I put into your life, I'm going to fix your home.
Hallelujah.
So things is already turning because I'm back at the hospital praying for the sick.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
And you said she works in this Atlantis here?
She's one of the managers.
Wow. So our program that we're doing is actually also touching them. Yes. They are beginning to go to church. Somebody go after Jesus. God bless you, Jesus. Morton, hold it, man. Hold on. You okay? Yeah. Why is it shaking?
Every time you get in the spirit,
it's shaking. So is it the gift of healing or is it something? So when you pray for people, they get healed.
Every time I go back to the hospital, people I saw, they went home.
She said every time she goes to the hospital, people should pray for them. They go home.
And rising up and picking up your stuff and
leaving.
Okay.
It is one. Hallelujah.
Yes.
You know when you guys were singing, God was telling me, I'll call you for testimony. You don't understand. She really wanna give her all. And I come and stand there. Come on. This testimony must be heavy. Amen. Is there somebody else after her? Anybody else have a testimony? Okay, come on, give her the mic, sorry.
I want to give God thanks for.
Put it close to you.
I want to give God thanks for Sister Edge from.
She can help you hold it.
Because I don't be on Facebook.
But
Sister Edge from told me about.
Where is Sister Edge?
The woman of God.
God bless you, sorry.
Oh my God. God bless you, Sister Edge. Jesus. I have a son in the hospital. Right now. I'm a pastor.
He's a pastor?
No, I'm a pastor.
Okay.
I have a son in the hospital right now. They can't seem to find what the problem is. But Sunday night, the Spirit of God, because I am an intercessor. The Lord said to me, he don't really live with me, but some of his clothes in me. The Lord said, I want you to go and get a red shirt. And I got 2 shirts. One is a mixed color with red in it, and it's plain red.
Yes, Philip, can you slow down? We can't hear her, so don't do that. Yeah, so that they can hear online.
And
she doesn't speak loud.
I got the shirt, and the Lord said he want me to sleep with the shirt and pray. As I prayed throughout the night and I dropped sleep, the very next day, my daughter took him to the hospital. He didn't even want to go. She took him to the hospital, and they ran some tests. And he was weak. He could hardly breathe. His chest and stuff. So, when they came home that evening, she said, ammonia. You know ammonia.
So that's pneumonia.
Ammonia, pancreas ammonia. So anyway, they told her after the test, after the x-ray, they call her and tell her bring him in right away. His lungs, one of his lungs had collapsed. They couldn't find, it was a lot of fluid around his lungs and stuff. And so.
Okay, tell us what happened.
And so, they had to put a hole in his ribs to pull out the fluid so they could get to the lungs. There was so much fluid around his lungs. And since Tuesday, when I woke up Tuesday morning, the Spirit of God had me. Sometimes he would tell me to go down and pray. Sometimes I would just pray from the bed. And so I went down and kneeled and I began to pray, sing to the Lord and all of that. The Lord said to me, what you were saying, woman of God, earlier. The Lord said to me, God said, I want you to get rid of fear and doubt. And then he had me to stand up. I was lifting my hands, praising and singing. And then the Lord just had my hand like this. He's like cutting everything from around me. He just had me cutting and cutting everything from around me. And so when he went and they had to cut him and everything, I believe all that what God was showing me, that he was cutting everything from around me concerning my boy. So he went in Tuesday. They was working on getting all that thing from around his lungs and stuff. And so he sent me this picture. Send me this picture I'm gonna show you.
The keyboard is too low, this is quite here. Alright, this testimony has taken longer than I expected. You went into stories too much. Is he healed now?
Well,
the fluid okay. Coming out, and so now he's getting healed. He's still in the hospital now.
Okay. So the testimony is you prayed and God healed him.
Yes.
Somebody clap for Jesus.
Amen. Yeah, that's where I come and give God glory.
Praise the Lord. Testimonies are good, but when the stories are too much, it takes away the sweetness. This is Bahama, so I'm a little patient, but normally at my other programs, I want you to tell us what happened. You understand what I mean? Because we're waiting for the testimony. May God heal him completely. In the name of Jesus. Amen. He kind of wanted to kill my body. I was all excited in the stories and but it's your son, so I know how it feels. You understand? And that's, as we were talking, I was just sharing it was an attack. It's not normal. But because God led you to testify, and you did, he is healed. In Jesus' name. How many of you here are sick? You have a kind of sickness that you take medicine for all the time? You take medicine all the time? Come on, come line here if you take medicine every day. I'm going to ask you what it is. How many? There was a lady I prayed for in Jacksonville, Florida. She takes, is it 38 pills or 32 pills? Who remembers? Was it 32 or 30? She takes 30 pills a day. She had almost everything wrong with her.
32
pills. Oh, you guys watching? I've seen so many people, so I don't remember the exact number. 33 pills, right? Oh, see for the testimony. God bless you. What is that? Testimony? Okay. And when I went to Jacksonville, Florida, somebody invited her and brought her. And by the time she came out and I laid hands on her, the demon left. There was one demon that caused it all. She had high blood pressure, everything you can think of. She said when she takes pills, sometimes when she's brushing her mouth in the morning, blood will come out of her nose. The pills don't really go down. It's 30-something daily for 8 years. 3. After that, she healed. No more pills. She was able to get back to work again, because she couldn't work. I go to work, and she got to speak in tongues the next day for the first time at the program. So as she was talking about her son now, God is leading me to pray for those that take pills. I mean, let me take one a day. One pill a day. Two. You take two a day. You guys take more?
I take four.
You take four a day? Come on, come close to me. So what are you taking pills for?
I'm taking Synroid for my thyroid. I get it over. They say the thyroid is the Synroid.
You can
thyroid.
Put one close to the other. You don't have to many ones.
They said the Synroid is the put back of the thyroid was producing.
How long has this been?
About 19 years.
My God. So you've been taking four pills a day?
No, I take one Synroid a day. But I take two sugar pills and pressure pills.
Okay.
And also I take three different medications in my eyes.
So you believe that when I pray for you, you'll be healed?
Yeah, that's what I'm here.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And you watch the videos or someone invited you?
Yeah, I the baby with Justina, she said to me, she said, you got to
she just invited you? She was just invited.
Yeah, she said it to me. She said it to me about 2 days ago before Friday.
Wow.
And I work right in Atlanta and only 2 days I get. Two days for this week. So I say,
so you work here too. A lot of you guys work here.
Yeah,
wow. So you're off today?
Yeah, God, what we can speak right after he gave me the 3 days days. I would say from Friday.
Wow.
So 3 days.
God fixed that up. I like that.
Yeah. And then when I was watching it, you would say, pray with water. And I get the water. And I let God over the water.
And you drink it. And it works for you.
Yeah.
You guys should be referring people to that, at least a water video.
Yeah.
3 minutes or 12 minutes one. They have nothing to lose, but so much to gain. It kicks out demons and sicknesses. Come on, let me pray for you. Right now, you don't feel anything, right? Okay. I usually sprinkle this in your life. You can put this down. Just relax. I always say relax. And don't say anything. And it was fire. Close your eyes. Take a deep breath. Thank you, Jesus. Just close your eyes. Hold those fire over your body. Fire from your head to your toe. You demon of sickness, it's time for you to leave her alone. Out of her! The name of Jesus! I command total healing in your body. And from today, you will never take any medicine again. The thyroid problem, the blood sugar, or whatever problem it is, I declare all of them gone. In the name of Jesus, as I have said, so shall it be. You are healed. No more medicine. In Jesus' name. Somebody clap for Jesus. Do you believe what I just said?
Yes.
Do you know how you believe?
That's why
you don't take medicine no more.
Yeah.
And nothing will happen to you. You'll be fine. Don't say you believe and tomorrow you're taking the pills. You know what I'm saying? There are some people, they say they believe, but they're still taking pills. So how do you know you believe? So don't take it again. You send me a message that I'm not taking my pills for a month and I'm fine. Let's do a week. After 1 week, you message me. You are free.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Don't believe when you come here. Come on, Tony. You say you take two pills a day for high blood pressure. All right. And you've had it for a long time. And you're tired of it. Yeah, come on. Sorry. Close your eyes. You spirit of high blood pressure. It's time for you to go. On the count of three, pack your things and leave. One, two, three. Out of her!
the name of Jesus. You are free in Jesus' name. Don't take it no more. What happened to you? Wait, give me mic, please. Don't.
I just feel this pounding in the back of my head.
Wow, when I was praying, you were feeling something pounding.
I just feel this pounding and this heartbeat.
Wow. And then suddenly, how do you feel now?
I'm feeling good now.
Wow, so this short prayer, there was a pounding and heat. Because I saw her do like, like you came back to yourself. That thing has gone.
Thank you, Jesus.
You are free now. In Jesus' name. Don't take that medicine no more.
Yes,
God bless you. Come on, sweetie. And do you take how many pills a day?
Four.
Wow. And what is it for?
Lupus.
Oh, lupus. Is that the one that your body hurts? Mm-hmm. And what else is a sign?
So far, like it got my lungs.
Your lungs?
Yes. But right now, it's, I have my lupus symptoms with my knees and my hands. They started to crack.
Wow. You've had this for a long time?
And so, yes. 8 years now.
8 years, four pills daily?
Yes.
Does the pill help in any way?
So far, but then I noticed, like I said, now the symptoms is now being starting to get aggressive.
More. Mm-hmm. How do you feel right now as you're talking to me?
So far, my left leg is giving me problems before I came.
It's hurting you?
Mm-hmm.
So you can't, you feel pain there now?
Yes, ma'am.
And your
my fingers is
are they hurting?
Yes.
So it's like pain all over your body.
Mm-hmm.
Do you work?
Yes, I do.
Here?
Yes, not right here, but in another.
So you work with this pain?
Yes.
Is it standing walk or sitting work?
Standing.
Move with around. The pain.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah. People are suffering. How are you able to do this?
I guess it's gold.
You have to pay bills, so you have to do that. It is welcome. You believe that when I pray, you will heal. Just release your breast. Release yourself. Come on. Is your heart beating fast?
No.
You're not nervous? Okay. Oh, that sound. Is it her phone? Something. Okay, pretty nice. Will this fire? Open it one more time. Close your eyes. Relax. Don't say anything. Take a deep breath. Fire from your head to your toe. You spirit of lupus. It's time for you to go. Your time is up. Out of fire! Name of Jesus! What happened to you when I shouted? Did I touch you?
I felt a sensation.
Sensation, how did that feel?
It felt light.
Hi!
Yeah.
When they say they feel light, do you know what that means? Something left them. Wow, it was a demon.
Thank you, Lord.
Just one shout.
Hallelujah!
Hey! Yeah.
Hallelujah! Thank you, Lord. Thank
you. Said, I felt light. Check your body, how you feel from head to toe. Just check.
Right now, I can feel like a sensation is running down.
It's the
my
anointing.
Legs.
It's the anointing. Come on, Sonic. You know, we've been worshiping a lot in this service. Today is for everyone to totally be free.
Amen.
You even look different. You see, I'm so now. And she looked younger, or is it my water?
No.
Did you see?
Yeah, it's chair up.
No, I'm not kidding.
Amen.
I'm watching her. It is well. Wow. How about your knee? Check it. Do something you couldn't do. You see, your knee was hurting. Give her the mic. You say what? Wow.
Yes.
How is it?
Well, it's not me. If I do that, I can only feel like painful.
Wow. Do it again. So now? You don't feel anything.
No.
Ha, 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 ha. Is somebody clapping for Jesus? He said, wow. The thing that left you that made you feel like is what has been doing this to you.
Thanks, Lord.
You are free in the name of Jesus. No more lupus, no more pills. Strength in your bones, no more pain. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Go and celebrate.
Amen.
Wow! I told you, when you come here, you just believe. Without faith, I can't do anything. Our wonderful thing, come here, sweetie, come close. You take how many pills?
Okay, I take too many vitamins, supplements.
Vitamins is different from what we're saying, right?
Yeah, what happened? I need to be delivered from them because
Oh, you want to be delivered from vitamins?
Too many supplements.
Too many. I thought the same vitamins are good for you.
Yeah, they're good for you.
But yours is too much.
Dependent. Yeah, and around 2015, I detoxed twice. And then I went and did it another time. And it was just too many. It was too heavy on my body. And ever since then, when I eat, I don't feel good. It doesn't matter what I eat sometimes. I just don't feel
when you
good.
Take too many vitamins, how many a day?
So I would take about, sometimes I was taking like about 9 garlic tablets a day.
What?
And 2 cinnamon.
Vitamins, what does vitamins do for us? Replace something in our body? What are we trying to replace in this body?
No, like when I ate anything with salt, I didn't feel good. But when I take the garlic...
Okay, so you want to be delivered from vitamins?
No, I just want to feel okay. Eat like everybody else. I'm allergic to MSG.
Okay.
I had suffered anemia for many years.
You just want to be healed.
I need to be healed.
That's right. Come on, Trey. Move it. And be delivered from too many vitamins. I'm enjoying my supplements, right? I don't like vitamins, they're so big. My vitamins come from heaven.
Amen.
That's right. How many of you want heavenly vitamins? Receive it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That's right. All right, just relax. Take a deep breath. Open your eyes. Holy Ghost fire. Don't say anything now. Now close your eyes. Fire from your head to your toe. Come out, you demon of sickness. Allergy. She says she's allergic to something. MSG. You spirit of allergies or whatever you called. And you spirit that is making her depend on so many supplements. The name of Jesus. Come out. In Jesus' name. From today I declare you free and healed. You will begin to feel, you say you want to feel like everyone else. You are healed. You will feel good. And you will no longer need all of those supplements again. In the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
It is all true. You know, you have already prayed for you when you were playing.
Yes.
It is well with you. Somebody clap for Jesus. Come on, sweetie. Come on, Mama. How many pills did you take?
One pressure tablet and stick myself twice.
You take one blood pressure tablet and 6 medicine?
No.
2
insulin.
2 insulin. Oh. What's insulin for diabetes?
Yes.
And how long have you had this?
About 10 years.
Wow. How do you feel right now in your body? Not too good. So the insulin is daily?
Yeah.
Wow. Is that how they do it?
Mm-hmm.
And that costs you money too, right?
Not necessarily. Not really. I'm government.
Okay. It is well. So you don't want to take those things no more?
No.
All right.
Horrified of needles.
And you believe that when I pray for you, you'll be healed? All right. I like when you guys believe. It's easy. Just relax. Take a deep breath. Online, if you're watching and you're diabetic, tap into this prayer right now. Open your eyes. Holy Ghost fire. One more time. This is the blood of Jesus. I just pray for water and I'm using it. Close your eyes. Relax. Holy Ghost fire all over your body, from your head to your toe. You spirit of diabetes, it's time for you to leave this woman alone and go to hell where you belong.
the name of Jesus, come out of this body and don't you ever come back again. Receive strength in your bones. In the name of Jesus, no more insulin, no more the other pill you take. In the name of Jesus, angels begin to fix her body. I want her to be made whole from head to toe. 1, 2, 3. Out! Jesus' name. You are healed. In Jesus' name. Give her a mic. How do you feel? You feel like, see, you see this water I sprinkle is already kicking it out, but you're healed. Don't take no insulin no more. I can tell you you're healed, but you still take it and then it means you doubt. Don't take it no more and you'll be strong. Okay? It is well with you. You guys, when I pray for you, I see you change and you look younger in front of me.
Mm-hmm.
Those spirits are evil. God bless you, sweetie. How many pills you taken in?
But I'm signing the agreement with my mother. She's at pressure points.
Oh, you're standing for your mom.
And I'm standing for myself because I have chest pain. So my mother,
you have chest pain?
Yes.
And your mom has chest pain too?
No, she has pressure. She takes drugs every day.
And this chest pain, it's hurting right now?
It's feeling right here.
On your right breast?
On my right breast. Yes.
And how long has it been?
Off and on. Off and on. For a year now.
It just started from nowhere? Or you hit her? You fell down?
No, nothing like that. Nothing.
Okay. How are you feeling right now as you're standing in front of me? Are you feeling nervous or something?
No.
Come close. So you feel the pain now?
No, I can feel the pain now.
Okay, but it comes on and off.
It comes on and off.
Okay. Alright, just relax. Put your hand down. Just relax. Don't speak in tongues yet. After the prayer, you can speak in tongues. It's okay. Give her the mic, she said she has something to say.
I have an ear here, it's my girlfriend from the state. She's in Atlanta now, and she follows you. She said you have her on the wall, Tonya. And she said, you got to get there, that's my friend, because he was coming when I told her I come to the state. Me and I was driving where you are. And so happens that you came here in the Bahamas. She said, you got to go. I said, I got to go here. And I got to go. It was raining in the rain, but I had to get here. And thank God I'm in the presence, not here.
Hallelujah. And God bless your friend. Is it Tanya? For inviting her. She's probably watching. God bless you, baby. Come on. Just relax. I'm not the one doing it. Jesus is the one, okay? Open your hands with me. You're tapping for your mom as well? Now just relax. Close your eyes. Holy Ghost, fire over your body. Fire from your head to your toe. Your spirit of chest pain. It's time for you to go. You that is making her, don't say it, making her mom sick, high blood pressure. On the count of three, all of you go. 1, 2, 3. Out! In the name of Jesus, come out of her! In Jesus' name. He says she's free. You are free. Your mom is free. You will never feel that chest for me. Make sure you send your testimony now. When you guys have healing or whatever, come back and testify. Alright, so you take pills a day?
Yeah.
How many?
For high blood pressure, depression. As I told you, I was depressed.
So how many total?
Two.
How many pills a day total?
Two.
Okay. And you want to stop?
Yeah.
When I pray, will you stop?
I will.
Next one. No, you took
some, I need some additional vitamins, but I would steal my vitamins.
Vitamins are not what we're trying about. Vitamins are
good. It's the blood pressure and the breast tick.
No problem. Put your hand down. Relax. Come closer. Open your eyes. Don't close fire. Close it. Just relax. Just close. Your spirit of depression and high blood pressure, it's time for you to leave her. Enough is enough. Out of her! The name of Jesus! I command total healing from head to toe. From today, you will never need those pills. No more depression. No more high blood pressure. You are healed. You are free in Jesus' name.
Amen.
It's as simple as that. Go and enjoy your life. No more pills. God bless you, Mama. You take pills too?
High blood pressure.
Hey, blood pressure is becoming too much. Maybe I need to do a video strictly for high blood pressure. Bless water just for blood pressure.
Yes.
And I will kick it out. So how many pills are you taking in?
Just one.
Just one. And you want to stop it?
Yes.
Come on, sweetie. Close your eyes. Let this fire over your body. Out of her! The name of Jesus! He used you as the point of contact for every member of your family that is sick. Angels, go and deliver all of them. From today, you will not need that pill again. No more high blood pressure. You are free. Your family is free. In the name of Jesus. And every evil charm that they have planted around you or in your house or somewhere, I dig it out now. In the name of Jesus. I sprinkle the blood of Jesus around your house. In the name of Jesus. And whoever has done anything to you or your family, Holy Ghost fire on them. You will confess and die. In Jesus' name. You are free. Why are you crying? Did something happen?
I was going through so much. Jesus.
I just kept hearing charms. I don't know. Charms. But you are free now.
God bless you, woman of God.
You are free. So anybody else here sick or everybody fine? You sick? Your knee hurts? Come on, guys. Come on. Hello, sir. How are you? What's wrong with you, sir?
I just have asthma.
Asthma?
Yes, ma'am.
So you take inhaler?
Yes, ma'am.
It's terrible?
I sleep two every morning.
You do?
Yes.
You take twice a day?
Twice in the morning.
Twice in the morning. You did today too?
Yes.
Wow. And you've had it for years?
Actually, I was born and born and it has.
When you were born?
I had it under control. And through my fault, it became back.
Alright. Put your hand down. Open your eyes. Close your eyes. Relax. Just relax your hand. Take a deep breath. Holy Ghost fire over your body. You spirit of asthma. It's time for you to leave this man. Come out of him. On the count of three, go to hell where you belong. One, two, three. Out! In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. You are healed. You will not have whatever makes you take that thing again in the mornings, okay? It's gone. Come on, today. You were here on Friday, Saturday, Sunday. I saw you in the kitchen this morning. Or was it today or yesterday when I was getting food? Oh, you saw me? You did? Why didn't you give me more food? I'm just kidding. I was like, oh, she came all the way from the kitchen to here. What's wrong with you? Let me pray for you.
I really stand again for my properties, two properties.
Your
teacher,
who?
My,
your children?
And my two properties.
Are they feeling sick?
One of them, yes.
Okay, what's wrong with them?
I've been small, don't you? Yeah, lose the walk, I don't walk with. On her eyes, she had only seen one of her eyes.
So one, someone, something with her eyes? And one doesn't
the,
walk well?
The nose. She, the bone will stay on the top.
Okay. So you want God to heal them. And for you, what do you want?
I want more sin.
You just want to
more of him.
Want more of God.
Amen. Hallelujah.
I want more him. So I don't know if I get him.
Hallelujah.
Wow, I like that. God bless you. Come on.
And this is for two people that are praying. Okay. Open your eyes. I'm going to use you as a point of contact. Just close your eyes. I'm going to just fire all over your body. Fire on those people that I'm using you as a point of contact to pray. Every sickness, I command them to come out now. Angels, go begin to heal them now. I work with healing angels and deliverance angels. Out of them, in the name of Jesus. I declare them healed in the name of Jesus. And for you, just close your eyes. Thank you, Father. Receive a fresh fire, fresh anointing and power. From today, the love of God will fill your heart like never before. In the name of Jesus, it is all with you. In Jesus' name. God bless you, Israel. This is your knee. Let's see the knee.
As I am here, I want to stand in the gap for my sister who's in a wheelchair in Florida. She's in a wheelchair in Florida, and she's...
Does she watch the videos?
All the time. Okay. She's sort of disabled, and as I'm believing God for my knee, because I believe that I'm afflicted with something, it's because it's for somebody else. But I'm also...
How long has it been?
This just started like about a week ago, but yesterday it wasn't, you know, it wasn't bothering me, but today it started to bother me.
So it just hurts.
Yes, and I'm believing God for my vision and for my teeth.
So your teeth hurts?
I want new teeth. So I'm hearing God for new teeth, and I'm believing God for 2020.
Hallelujah.
I'm believing God for that so I can read more. I want to be able to. It hurts, you know.
What knee is it? This one? Okay. All right. Okay. Come closer. Open your eyes. Open your mouth. Close your eyes. Relax. Take a deep breath. You say, ask and you'll receive, right? Mm-hmm. Holy Ghost, fire over your body. Fire on the knee. Angels, fix the knee. Fix her eyes. She says she wants new teeth. Give it to her. And the one on the wheelchair, begin to heal her as well. The name of Jesus, hold her. Jesus, you were supposed to hold her. You just let the lady fall. Leave her now. She don't need to hold her again. She's already enough. Praise the Lord. Get up, sweetie. Something jumped out of her. Who's holding the mic? Let's see this. Sorry, Sweeney. You were able to kneel down. Look at that. Rakata. What happened to you? I was still praying. Did something push you back?
Yes.
Give me a mic, please.
I felt a force.
When I shouted out.
Yes.
Something pushed you in. Came
yes.
Out. How does it mean?
It still hurt.
So what do you think came out? You don't know. You couldn't control it.
No, it just pushed me back like boom.
And how do you feel now? Like light? Like something jumped out of you?
I feel, yeah, it's like, I can't explain it.
Peace. It was so bad, I was getting mad at her for not catching you, but you didn't break your back or nothing.
No, I just... My knee just... Well, I got a little kink in my knee. Still feel like a little kink, but I know that I'm here.
Whatever came out of you is controlling whatever is wrong with you.
Amen.
You are free.
I receive.
You are healed.
In Jesus' name.
And the lady is healed. Too.
Amen.
I receive it in Jesus' name. Wow.
That was unexpected. Come on, sweetie. What's wrong with you? I like when we come for the people here. I don't want you guys to all be coming for people that are not here. Okay. What did you come for yourself?
Okay, well, lately my eyes started to get blurry.
Lately? Mm-hmm. So you can't see clearly?
I can see, but if I use my phone sometimes, like, my eyes get blurry, but
and it started recently?
Yes.
So right now, you can see, but if you have your phone, it will be blurry.
Mm-hmm. I love the whole thing.
How do you feel right now as you're talking to me?
I feel fine.
Okay. And your son and daughter, what's wrong with them?
Well, my son, he's having the same problem all of a sudden.
With his eyes?
Mm-hmm. Wow. But his son is working. He wakes up literally crying because his eyes water him.
And your daughter the same thing?
My daughter, she's born constipated.
She's always constipated?
When she's born.
How old is she now?
She just turned 2 yesterday.
So your daughter is always constipated? Your son is having the same eye problem that you're having.
Yes.
So it's an attack. So there's no way two of you will be having the same thing at the same time.
Okay.
Come on, sweetie, let me pray for you. Relax, just allow this long dress to flow. Don't be afraid. Please, come near them. Don't try to run from them. See, this is my lead usher, I don't know what happened. I think she's on vacation too. We're in Bahamas, so she's doing vacation. Relax, eh? Open your eyes. One more time. Holy Ghost fire. I'm using you as a point of contact for your son as well and your daughter. Now close it. The demon that is trying to blind them. It's time for you to leave. And you that is making our daughter constipate. Out of her! In the name of Jesus! Pack your things and go. Now remove that thing you put in their eyes. Quick. Remove it. Remove it. Not you, how you like this. Are you dating mom?
No.
Okay. This isn't me. She said, remove it. I said, no. Yeah, you didn't. Are you dating mom? You said, no. This is like the funniest deliverance ever. I talked to demons. Not you. It's a spirit I'm talking to. But I have fun. My house is so different. Just don't be too conscious. Let me do it. It's not that serious. Okay? The same way it started, that you did not know it. Believe like that. Be healed in the name of Jesus. No more blurry vision. Your son is healed. Your daughter will no longer constipate. You are all free in the name of Jesus. Receive joy in your heart. In the name of Jesus. I'm just hearing that you need joy. I don't know why. Is it true? You do need joy? I just heard it to receive it. It is done.
Amen.
Do you have a phone?
Yes.
Are you able to? You said, it was it blurry before you came on the phone?
Yes, ma'am.
So let me get a phone. Let's. Is this her phone? Wait. Where's your phone? Go get your phone. Hallelujah. Okay, open your phone. He has done it all for me.
Normally
you hold it down.
Mm-hmm.
So how is it now?
It's clear.
Are you guys hearing it? I didn't hear you. What did you say?
It's clear.
He said it's clear now. Before she would have to hold it because it's so blurry. But now, look again, look at your phone very well. Because if you're healed and you believe in your son,
yes,
so it's clear.
Yes,
before you came here, it was not clear.
No, I had to hold it like that. Look at
it. You were telling her the same.
I was sitting at home and my husband was texting me. I don't know.
She said she was sitting at home, her husband was texting her. She couldn't read it. But now, check your husband's text. It's clear?
I told him I was in church. I had to hold it down.
You have to hold it. So your vision is clear. You are free. That spirit has left you.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Come on, sweetie. What's wrong with you?
Sometimes I start
moving object on your leg?
And my feet.
Your feet? Sometimes. When was the last time you felt it?
A couple minutes.
Sometimes
in the kitchen, but in my home.
In your home?
Mm-hmm.
When you're in the house?
Yeah.
In the kitchen?
Yeah.
Just the kitchen only?
Yeah, sometimes around the kitchen area.
Hi. So wait, so the moving object only moves when you enter the kitchen?
Yeah, that's mostly when I feel it. Yes. So sometimes
this is some strange one.
Sometimes I just check it. You know, something.
And moving. How long has it been? Okay, come closer. Let's kill that thing. Open your eyes. Open it again. Close it. Relax. Take a deep breath. You spirit of moving object, it's time for you to leave right alone. Holy Ghost fire on you and in your house, in that kitchen. Whatever is there, fire, 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 fire on this leg right now. Out of fire! The name of Jesus. And don't you ever come back again. I sprinkle the blood of Jesus all over your house. Every evil thing in the house, I remove it. In the name of Jesus, I declare you free. No more moving objects. In the name of Jesus. Amen.
Thank you.
You are free.
Thank you, Jesus.
You always watch me now. So send your testimony, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
God bless you, please. Come on. Clap for Jesus. Moving object.
Yeah.
Wait, wait, when you go into the kitchen. Are you guys friends?
And
he said, I have the same problem. How can two people have kitchen problem? They all eat too much or what? So maybe the moving object doesn't want you going to eat. Laughing, man. Let's have fun, man.
Right. It moved around here, and then I feel like something rested on my back.
Like a weight.
Yes, and I feel heat coming out of this leg here.
Is it uncomfortable?
Heat. No, it's just like a warm heat just releasing every so I don't know what it is.
Are you sure it's not Holy Ghost fire?
I don't know.
Is it
uncomfortable? Sometimes my feet, it's not uncomfortable. Sometimes my feet get very hot.
Because I always have fire coming out of my feet.
Oh,
I don't know your fire.
I don't know what it just started happening last week, so I said, I don't know. Yeah, and I wanted to put my daughter to, she has suffered PCOS or something that breathing that's too much.
Okay.
Anxiety.
All right, come on. So the movement is moving now in your belly right now.
Yeah.
Right now.
It's not moving right now.
When was the last time you felt it?
This morning.
And the weight is still on your back?
Yeah.
It's like an added flesh?
Yeah, it's been there for a long time.
How many years?
Since last year.
And then the one on the feet, only when you enter your kitchen to eat?
Yeah, when I go to the table. I don't know, there's somebody more than crazy.
At least you're not the only one with the kitchen problem. I like this one. I've never heard this before. Come on, let's take care of it. You have faith now. You've been at so many programs. Just relax. This woman doesn't want to let go of that bag. You don't know if everything he has is there. Open your eyes. Alright, it was fire. Close it. Relax. You moving object in the belly. It's time for you to go. The weight in the back, melt away. The one on the leg or the feet, no more. Come out. And I'm using you as a point of contact. The bleeding, excessive bleeding, I command it to stop. And whatever it is that you see she have, Holy Ghost fire both of you right now. Fire, 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 fire. Even in your house, fire, 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 fire. Out of her! The name of Jesus! You are free. And your daughter is free. In Jesus' name. I like how you guys clap for my Jesus. God bless you, sweetie. What's wrong with you? Put your hand down. Just relax. Don't worry.
I broke my hand. A couple months ago, I fell on the river.
before now, two months ago? Pain in your hand?
Yes, now.
The two or just one?
It was Saturday, it was there, but like pain moved from one hand. And like when I sleep, and like my hand is sleeping now.
Okay, so right now is your hand, your two hands paining you?
Yeah, like I go like that. You know when you say prayers.
Can you raise your two hands up now? It's painful?
Yeah, this like this one is
painful. This one is painful. Yeah. So what can't you do? Are you able to hook up your brain?
After that, yes. After I really, you know, like try to reach in the back.
And it hurts. Yes. And this one especially, not mostly this one.
No. Once
and you fell.
Yes.
Alright. So you want that pain to be gone.
Yes.
Yeah, come close. Open your eyes. Put your hand down. Just relax. Relax. Okay? Close your eyes now. Relax. Take a deep breath. Holy Ghost, fire your hand, fire, fire, all over your body, fire. You spirit of pain, it's time for you to go. On the count of three, leave this woman alone. One, two, three, out! Out! In the name of Jesus! Receive total healing. No more pain. In Jesus' name. Now, just raise up the two hands.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank
do your back. Do something you couldn't do before. So, from that time, when you do that, you feel?
Yes,
you can't do that. But how do you feel now?
I feel good.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
The people here, you guys have faith. That's why you are just working to receive. God bless you, Jenny. What's wrong with you?
I'm going to get this pain like at the back of my neck.
Pain?
My feet is always hot and I'm talking about the fire. They're putting the fire off you on me, so I think that's what my feet is on.
So your feet is always hot?
Always hot in the night, especially at night.
Is it uncomfortable?
No, it's just feel hot.
I mean, but something is coming out of it.
Yeah,
and
sometimes
I
feel like my hands feel like sometimes
I
feel like my hands are on fire.
So you
say
you've been wanting the fire
from
me?
Oh yeah, I keep calling it every day.
You say you've been calling fire every day, now you got fire. Be careful what you call for that. But when was the last time you felt it?
Yesterday. And then I also want to stand in the gap for my husband. You know, I'm trying to get him off these blood pressure tabs. He's about six of them.
Six.
That's on my high.
Does he believe in God?
Yes, he.
Okay, so if I pray now, will he believe that he's healed?
Yes. Okay. Make sure that I go into the room.
So the pain in your neck is still there?
No, not. Mostly at night.
Everything happens to you at night. The fire comes at night.
Everything comes at night.
Oh my God, this is so funny.
I have to try, when I try to sleep at night, then sometimes like, I have all these dreams. The other night, like five dogs attacking me. So I go up and my whole body, I felt like I was having a stroke on the left side.
Witches.
Yeah,
those are witches.
Yeah, they, you know, and that's like the third dream I had with these dogs.
That's not a good dream.
One lady told me in the dream, I saw a lady in the dream, she said, you know too much, you're up in people's business. Time for you to go.
You know too much?
Mm-hmm. She said, it's time for you to go.
Time for you to go, so they want to kill you. Which is what. But you're not afraid of them.
No, I'm a witch killer. I'll kill them all.
Open your eyes. I don't know if you watch my videos, but me and us, I don't pardon witches. We do that which must
die. That which
must die.
Close your eyes. Relax. Take a deep breath. Holy Ghost fire all over your body. I need total cleansing right now. Every evil deposit in your system, fire. From your head to your toe, buckets of fire. Fire on your neck, your belly, your hand, your leg. Fire in your house. Fire on your sheets, your bed sheets. Fire all over your house. Whatever they have put there, fire. Out of her! The name of Jesus! Come out of her! The name of Jesus! From today, no more pain in your neck. No more moving object in your belly. And every strange fire, I command it to stop from now on. In the name of Jesus, let those witches that were attacking you, fire on them. Let them begin to confess wherever they are. Confess wherever they are. Confess wherever they are. Out! In the name of Jesus, I declare you free and your husband is healed. In Jesus' name. Come on, Shelly. What happened to you? You can get up. You're weak. Something jumped up. You are free. You won't see the other witches again.
Hallelujah.
Hold that, please. Thank you for holding that because your vacation is over. Come on, sir. What's wrong with you? When does menopause start? 50 something? 60? 40. 30? I'm 38 now. I haven't seen menopause. I thought it's 45, 50. Is it 50? Yours came early. So is it, what does it do? It causes hot flashes or what? What does it do?
Hot flashes, you know, speeds up your heart rate,
headaches,
all sorts of stuff.
Menopause is like that?
Yes. Yeah. It's different with everybody. Everybody, some people have cold chills, because my mom had cold chills. But I just started and I just have a little, but some people get cold chills.
So some people's home goes like a little hot. So yours is like too much.
Too much.
So you want all of those signs to just stop.
I'm ready to turn the corner.
Yeah. Come on, sweetie. If you are watching online and you're dealing with menopause and all that, be healed in the name of Jesus. Yeah. And anyone here to receive your own healing in Jesus' name. I didn't know it was that bad. Now I'm afraid of menopause. Open your eyes. Open it wide. This is the blood of Jesus. I just turn water into this. Blood of Jesus. Open it one more time. Close your eyes. Fire all over your body. Fire, 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 fire. Ratabarika skobroni kandias kataya. Every sign of menopause that is making you uncomfortable, I want it all to stop now. In the name of Jesus, be healed in Jesus' name. Out of her! The name of Jesus. You will not feel any of those symptoms again. In the name of Jesus. Because you believe, you are free. In Jesus' name. And I was praying for her. I heard that she believes strongly. God bless you, sweetie. I like when you guys that are working here stopping by. That's awesome, man. What's wrong with you?
So, in 2011, I lost functionality of both of my kidneys. I got a transplant in September of 2017 at the age of 40. I'll be 42 this year. I want the fire of God to burn anything that may be remnant in my body. They said the cause of it was lupus. So the lady who came up, you prayed for lupus, that's my mom.
Wow, so your mom?
When my situation occurred before her situation.
So the two of you were dealing with lupus, but yours messed up with your two kidneys?
Yeah.
And you had two new kidneys?
I had a transplant, so I still, the old kidneys are still there. They're they don't move them.
Okay.
And I've had a transplanted kidney.
So this is definitely an attack, right?
Wow.
It is well. I'm off your glasses. Let's pray. People are suffering. Mama and daughter, come closer. Relax, just take a deep breath. You're feeling nervous? It is well. Make sure she doesn't fall on the floor. Just support her. Be nice. Then we lose fire. Fire, close your eyes. You demon of lupus, trying to mess with her kidneys. It's time for you to leave her alone. Leave this family alone. Out of her! The name of Jesus! Put your big and leave her. Fire! All over your body. From your head to your toe. Fire! Take everything you put in her. Remove it. Out! The name of Jesus! Rakanaba stick it in or scatter. Fire! Hold on. More fire. More. More. Angels, perform surgery on her. Fix those kidneys. Fire. More. 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 Come out! In the name of Jesus, on the count of three, chop off the head of this one. This demons. One, two, three. Chop it off! Out! In Jesus' name. You are free. You are healed. In Jesus' name. Somebody clap for Jesus. What happened to you? Like something was happening to your stomach? How are you feeling? Like there was so much power coming on you? You are free. That demon has left you.
Thank you.
In Jesus' name. Come on, friend. Before and after, every month.
Yeah.
Severe. Yeah. And you take medicine.
Yes, I have to take medication.
Like a migraine.
Yes.
And this has been going on for how long?
It started about 4 years ago.
So every month you expect this headache?
Yes.
My God. This month, have you had it?
Yes.
And once, it's the same routine. Your spirit of headache. It's time for you to leave her alone. I don't want you to ever come back to this one. Out of her! The name of Jesus! Out! In Jesus' name. Calabash, Kanta, Yalabash. Fire. 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 Hold on. Sorry. My girl is, she don't want to break her back, it's nice. Every other demon hiding in you, I flush them out of your system. Send them back to hell where they belong. In the name of Jesus. You are free and you are restored. You will be great. It is done. In Jesus' name.
It's the finish now.
What?
The power bank finish.
Come on, sweetie. What happened to you? You guys can explain. I don't know.